What we do is just simply understanding nature, understanding better our origin, understanding how matter is produced. I think it's one of the most essential questions we could answer to. I do not see anything better to do in life.
Alexandre Obertelli is an experimental nuclear physicist. He is currently developing a highly ambitious research project at CERN in Geneva. He wants to send antimatter on a journey to explore nuclei. This is highly complex because antimatter disappears immediately at the slightest contact with matter. Matter like the walls of a container, which is needed to trap them. Obertelli has been working on the implementation for 2 years.
Build such a device, a trap, you need a magnetic field in this case, and this is a blue can, so what we call a solenoid, that will maintain a strong longitudinal magnetic field along the axis of the cylinder. So finally, a particle in a trap will do cycles way and back along the trap axis. So we'll have such a behavior, of course, at a very high frequency.
The distance between storage and destination, 400 meters.
If we manage to transport antiprotons, it means that we can deliver antiprotons to laboratories and experiments with antimatter can be done elsewhere than CERN. And this will really, in some sense, democratize the use of antimatter. And then people may have new ideas, new type of experiments. And this, why not, may lead to some very specific applications that people didn't think about yet.
The elaborate transport pays off, because at the destination, radioactive nuclei are being produced and studied, Obertelli's real interest. By use of low-energy antiprotons, Obertelli will study the very surface of neutron-rich nuclei and hopes to track down largely unknown quantum phenomena. On the table of nuclides, the atomic nuclei are identified by their number of protons and neutrons. The black dots indicate the stable nuclei that are known. Beyond that, there are new worlds that Obertelli is exploring, the radioactive nuclei, which are unstable due to their neutron excess or deficiency. These nuclei are short-lived, and most of them do not exist in nature, so research knows little about them. To learn more about them and their properties, they have to be artificially made from accelerated beams of stable nuclei and studied before they decay. For some nuclei, this has already been achieved in the past, but many of these phantoms exist only in theory and could not yet be synthesized.
This is the reason why we have to build new facilities with more beam intensity to be able to explore this region of nuclei which has not been synthesized so far. And this region is called the terra incognita.
From 2025, Darmstadt will enable insights into this currently unknown world. One of the most complex accelerator facilities in the world is being built there at the FAIR Accelerator Center. This is one of the reasons why Alexandre Obertelli will take up his professorship at the TU Darmstadt.
For my field and nuclear physics, TU Darmstadt is maybe the best university to do nuclear physics. My colleagues are excellent experimentalists, but also theorists. There is a very strong theory component at the IKP, so the Nuclear Physics Institute of TU Darmstadt.
Obertelli will carry out experiments at both CERN and Darmstadt.
Yeah, so the Humboldt Fellowship gave me the means to do the science I want to do, but also the opportunity to come here to Darmstadt and build my own group. And really take the risk as you want, because this is your own decision and responsibility.
And Alexandre Obertelli loves the challenge. Above all else, he wants to question the theories of physics, point out the limits of knowledge, and break new ground.
There are questions which are either completely unanswered or only partially answered. And what can we provide, what new device we can provide, build, in order to answer these questions. And by trying, new ideas may come. And this is the fun of it, actually.
Darmstadt will offer new opportunities for Obatelli and his team to learn more about the Terra Incognita. And this very knowledge about matter and its structure on a small scale is also the key to understand giant stars and the origin of the elements within them.
Put yourself into this unknown and try to make sense out of it from experimentation to understand a piece of a puzzle, which is extremely important, is maybe the most driving aspects of this research.